guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today we are going to learn about the 64 static RAM, that is 7489 IC. So we know that we have two types of RAM, dynamic or static RAM. So basically the static RAM stores the information until it will turn off or until we change the address. So to study the static RAM, we have a trainer kit. The order code for this trainer kit is 38656. So this is the IC diagram of 64-bit static RAM, that is 7489 IC. So in this IC diagram we have two types of input. One is the address input. So address input are A1, A2, A3, A4, and we have a data input, that is I1, I2, I3 and I4. Similarly, in this we have a data output D4, D3, D2, D1. So in this 7489 IC, what we are going to do, that first of all, in this we are going to write the information. It means we are going to write the information in the IC. After then we are going to read the information using the 7489 IC. So to learn this RAM functioning, first of all turn on the training kit. So this is now training kit is on. So on this training kit we also have a WE bar. It means this SW6 switch will perform the operation of write, and this is a CE bar. It means it is a functioning of chip enable or chip disable. So to understand about the 7489 IC, I am going to do some connection. First of all, make T3 and T4 connections and T5 and T6 connection. So these are the operation, that is write operation, read operation of 7489 IC. So firstly we are going to do write operation. So for that the procedure are given. First of all, select the binary address with the help of SW1 to SW4 and data with the help of SW7 to SW10. Keep SW5 to logic state 0. Apply write pulse with the help of SW6 by changing it from logic 1 to 0 and logic 1. Repeat the step 1 to 3 till all the locations are filled with the desired information. So here I am having some information regarding to store the information in the IC. So in this I am having some address input. So these are the address input and I am going to store this data. So these are the data input. So turn on the training board. First of all, make the CE bar to logic state 0. So here CE bar at logic state 0, you can see. And now start storing the information. So here on address A4, A3, A2, A1 are 000, I am going to store the value I40, I30, I20 and I11. And so now we are performing the write operation. So I have some data to write the information in the IC. So these are the address input I am going to use and these are the data input that I am going to store the IC. Store the value in the IC. So on address 0000, so on address 0000, I am going to store the value 0001. So 0001, make the write switch. So here I have stored the value 0001. Now on next address, that is 0001, I am going to store the value 0110. So here 0110. Now write the information using the SW6 toggle switch. So here I have stored the value 0110. Now on the next address, that is 0110. I am going to store the value 0101. So 0101. Write it using the SW6 switch. Now on the next address, that is 0101. 0101. On this address, I am going to store the value 1100. So 1100. 1100. Write this information. Now on the next address, that is 0111. I am going to store the value 1111. 0111. On this address, I am going to store the value 1111. Write this value. So here I have write the value 1111 on address 0111. Now on next address, that is 1000, I am going to store the address, sorry, value 1010. So 1000, on this address I am going to store the value 1010. So 1010. So here we have completed the write operation. Now I am going to read this value using the address input. So what you have to do for read operation, don't change any chip enable and write. You have to change the address input and read the information in the output. So on first address, that is 000, I have stored the value 0001. So on the data output, we are going to observe same thing. So on address 0000, I have stored the value 0001. Similarly, on next address, that is 0001, I have stored the value 0110. So change only, you have to change the address input. So on 1000 means 0001, on this address I have saved the stored the value 0110. On next address, that is 0110. So 0110. On this address I have saved the value 0101. So you can see in the output we are getting same thing. Similarly, on next address, that is 0101. On this address I have saved the value 1100. So you can see in output we are getting same value. Similarly, on 0111, we have stored the value 1111. So same thing you can observe in the output. So on this address we can observe on 0111, I have stored the value 1111. You can see. Similarly, on next address, that is 1000, I have stored the value 1010. So same you can see in the output. So on 1000, I have stored the value 1010. So this is all about this read operation. So thank you for watching this video. For other queries, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.